You are now tuned in to JajasMike. It's a pleasure to have you. If this is your first time joining me, make sure you hit that subscribe button. I'm a firm believer that your life will be changed. Today, ladies and gentlemen, you probably would have witnessed this rock means, right? This rock is life in many ways. But today, I have a phenomenal, inspirational, motivated young brother by the name of Marcus Browne here to speak to you. So without further ado, let me pass the rock to Marcus Browne.
My name is Marcus Browne, graduated from Kemmler High School in Sugar Land, Texas, and right now at the moment I'm attending Simpson University in California. Today I just want to talk about, you know, my story, what basketball has done for me, and how it's allowed me to travel to California to play at the college level. Graduated from Kemmler High School, you know, it's a small school, no one knows about it. I was at therapy the other day and a guy came up to me, he said, what school you graduated from? I told him, Kemmler High School. He said, where is that located? And imagine how that hit me. Like, I'm a hooper, this is what I do. I'm trying to get exposure. I went to Kemmler High School, and I didn't get one recruit, not one offer. So, I mean, over that summer, I had to email every coach. I sent every coach in the United States my film, from D1 to D3. Yeah, I got a couple emails back, and a coach in California, in Redding, California, hit me back, and he liked my film, and he told me to come out there. So, I mean, but beyond that, I just want to talk about how staying consistent got me to be able to play basketball in California at the college level. Imagine just, like, you know you're cold enough to hoop. Like, hoopers, you know this. Like, when you're nice, you know you're cold enough to hoop. So imagine not having one person come up to you talking about you. And everybody's talking about everybody else in the city. But you know you're going to be relevant in the next couple of years to come. I knew where I was going to be at, and I felt like I didn't get the respect that was needed. What's glorified is someone that a lot of these kids from one and done. I mean, everybody talks about the NBA, and everybody talks about the one and done. And I'm not even trying to cover that topic. I'm trying to cover the topic that the kid that gets his degree because he was able to pursue basketball for 4 years. A kid like myself, I mean, I went to school for basketball. I woke up every morning at Kemmler High School to be with my boys, to enjoy that moment and be on the court. So I just feel like for a kid, even if basketball has to help you get through school, use it for that. Get back what you put into your investment. That's my main thing. And I just want to talk about a story that happened the other day. I was in class, and this girl apologized to me for not doing too well on my test. Now, I understand I didn't put the work in that was required for this test, but don't apologize to me because my creativeness might not be matched in that course. I mean, if we was to change the course to basketball, everybody in the same class, everybody looking at me like I'm the dumbest person in the class, change that same course to basketball, and I'm the valedictorian of that class. I'm the smartest person in that class, and we was to change the whole course to basketball. So I just don't feel like if you're good at basketball or you're good at something else, let that be your genius. Don't let the fact that you might not, like, this is art. Like, to be on the court, to do those crossovers, for someone to dunk the ball, that's art. So why would someone look at me as if I'm not capable or if I'm not smart because I'm not doing too well on the required stuff? But if you put me on the court, you can see my artistry. You can see what I do with the ball is art. So I feel like if you talk about art, if you talk about courses or anything, basketball has to come up because it's taught me this. Why can I not make money? I'm a businessman. Why can I not make money off of basketball? I understand that I put this much work into basketball. Why can I not make money off basketball first? Because I know I'm not a mathematician. I'm not an English teacher. So why not understand I can make money off of basketball first and put that same money I'm making into something I want to invest in? So why would that kid rush to get that job now knowing he can make just as much money off of basketball? So it's just like, you can get that money off of sports, something we put time into. We wake up every morning and put that money into the bank. So let's make sure we get that money back and then invest it into something else, all the stuff we learned from basketball. So it actually kind of hurt. It hurt me to see that I was in the class stressed out because I felt like there was not crediting my artistry, my genius. Why was it that what I was doing wasn't considered a skill? Why that kid that can get a contract for $40,000, $60,000 overseas, it's not look like, or it's not, why is he not, like, you're on the right path? Why is his stuff that he's doing is not considered smart, but the kid that got the 4.0 at A&M is the smartest kid on earth? So I just feel like the kid that can get that money overseas could do the same thing he could do. And I mean, the person I want to inspire is the kid that everybody's telling him. Everybody's telling him, like, how long are you going to hoop for? How long are you going to continue to hoop before you have to give it up? I want to touch that kid and let him know there's money. There's money out here. I mean, you see the NBA is one of the biggest leagues. I'm not saying, not even makes it to the NBA, but I'm saying there's money overseas. Every country wants their NBA. So there's jobs opening up. I feel like this is the generation of creators. Like, not everybody has to sit in the office no more. There's going to be athletic jobs opening up everywhere. And it's not easy, but I'm just saying, don't quit thinking that you're going to be able to make fast money off of getting, like, a job now. Why not try to get money that's going to last you longer and enjoy what you're doing to continue to put that passion and drive you need? Because some of my closest friends, once they gave up hooping, I'm not knocking any of them, but they're not, like, it's hard to keep that way, because when you're playing in a basketball game, when you're an athlete at school and everybody loves you, it's a type of high that it can't match unless you try to look for that high in a different way. So I just want that kid that feels like if he gives up hoop, he can make that money quicker. Because some of my closest friends, two of my closest friends are, like, in jail right now, and I used to hoop with them. So I feel like if they would have continued to play basketball, maybe been overseas by now, it would have been a different story. So, I mean, that's the reason why I put in work every day. That's the reason why I hoop, is because I want a kid that went to Kempner to say, he made it, I can make it. He's there making money, I can make money off of this, because there's a lot of money in this. And that's just one thing I want to get across. So don't look at the kid, or don't look at the player that says, I want to go to the NBA. Respect him the same way. Why would a kid say he want to be a doctor? Everybody loves the kid. Everybody wants to support the kid. But the kid that wants to play basketball or play a sport, the first thing he gets, if he's not already D1 bound, or the first thing he gets is, what you going to do after you're done? Why not support him and be like, hey, there's money. You can make money. The same way you can make money. It might take 7 years, but being a doctor, you got to go to school for 4 years, you got to go to school for 8 more years. You can make money off of basketball in the same amount of time. So I just feel like, being a basketball player, I just want that respect to where I say, if I play basketball, you look at me as if I'm just as capable, as just as smart as the kid that wants to be the doctor, or the kid that gets the internship. I'm at an internship every summer working. I'm out here working every summer. So this is my internship. My internship is basketball. Everything I've learned from it. And it's going to give me my job. That's why I play it. And I just want to stand up for that kid. I just want him to take pride in saying, I hoop, or I want to play overseas for until I'm 33 or until I'm 29. That kid. That's the kid I want to inspire. My name is Marcus Browne. I go to Simpson University, and I play basketball. MOAM.
Come on.